The time is 8:08 p.m. Good evening. The news headline. One thing Buhari would be remembered for when he leaves office in 2023. The news in full. President Muhammadu Buhari is being criticized by most Nigerians today. Most Nigerians criticize President Muhammadu Buhari on a daily basis because of one reason or the other. Though we might be having insecurity issues in different parts of the country, but that does not mean that President Muhammadu Buhari is a failure because he is trying his best, Ebuka 156 on September 22, 2021. He said, when President Buhari's tenure eventually comes to an end in the year 2023, he is going to be remembered by Nigerians because of what he did in the area of infrastructure. He said, before President Buhari came to power in the year 2015, we do not have any one good and functional rail line in Nigeria. But few years after he became the president of the country, things have changed. As it stands now, the Kaduna to Abuja rail line is working. The Lagos to Ibadan rail line is also working, and other ones. He said, then let's talk about the second Niger Bridge in Onitsha, Anambra State. Before President Buhari became the president of the country in the year 2015, there was nothing like second Niger Bridge, but as it stands now, work is ongoing and the bridge is going to be completed very soon. The writer says that he really thinks that President Buhari has done well a lot in the area of infrastructure, more than any other president in the history of Nigeria. He said President Muhammadu Buhari is really trying his best, and it is highly impossible to have a president or a leader that is 100% perfect. Even the president of the United States of America is not perfect. You can't get any perfect leader anywhere. He said, though many people will disagree with him, but we are all entitled to our own opinion. Yes, we might be passing through a whole lot of challenges in the area of security, but he doesn't think that Buhari is a failure. Yet, we remember that just quite a while, the Northern Elders Forum says that they are regretting that they ever made President Muhammadu Buhari the president of the nation by voting him in. People, is there anybody who would not tell you he wished President Muhammadu Buhari done better? We raised huge expectations. We told people, get rid of Jonathan. Put Buhari there. It would fix corruption. It would fix insecurity. It would fix the economy. But look at where we are now. How can anybody say they are happy with the record of President Buhari? Even the close people to him will tell you that they wished he has done better, or he could have done much better, and he hasn't. So what we did now is to get ready to elect another president who would go in the opposite direction. A president who has a vision and a clear idea of what governance is and what it involves, rather than just being a president. So I am disappointed, and that is why today I am actively involved in trying to see that a new leader emerges in getting Nigeria a new lease of life, he said. This is just a fraction of the Northern Elders Forum, who they have said that the North have paid a biggest price for Buhari's failure. The same spokesperson of the Northern Elders Forum, NEF, Akim Baba Ahmed, also said that the North has paid the biggest price for the failure of President Muhammadu Buhari's administration, and that the country's salvation is neither with the All Progressive Congress, APC, nor the People's Democratic Party, PDP. Baba Ahmed said that during a dialogue organized by an online newspaper, Ripples Nigeria, at the second annual dialogue on the theme "Rebuilding Trust in a Divided Nigeria, Advancing the Conversation" in Lagos. Other eminent Nigerians that spoke at the event were Governor Ifeanyi Okowa of Delta State, the acting leader of the Pan Yoruba Social Political Organization, Afeniferi Pa Ayo Adebanjo, and the former chairman of the National Health Insurance Scheme, Professor Usman Yusuf. Governor Okowa, who was the keynote speaker, expressed worry over the state of the country, saying that noting that the country Nigeria was actually passing through perilous time indeed. He said that Nigeria has never been this divided or witnessed such magnitude of mistrust of ourselves and our nation. He said Nigeria is better and stronger together with appropriate visionary leadership and good governance. we can turn our diversity into a great source of strength and a springboard to build a multi-ethnic and multi-religious country that will be the envy of other nations. As 2023 approaches, leadership is key and the focus should be on electing a pan-Nigeria as president, a person with the capacity and charisma to cast a vision for Nigeria and rally all Nigerians behind it. We need a selfless, sacrificial, sincere, broad-minded, caring, and capable president that will inspire hope and confidence in the country. He also lamented that the unending crisis in the country and labor agitations further placed a wedge between the citizenry and the leadership. According to Governor Okoa, he said that other challenges such as cybercrime, human trafficking, and others derived from a general discontentment with the leadership and the deplorable state of the country as of today. He said that there was a time that we happily sang, though tribe and tongue may differ, in brotherhood we stand. But what was that reality, or was that a reality or just an aspiration? On the first thought, it would seem like a reality, for at one time, Nigerians lived freely and effectuated themselves among ethnic groups other than theirs. Our history shows that that same time and beyond, Nigeria generally battled with the issues of mutual distrust, suspicion, prejudice with the various ethnic nationalities locked in battles for supremacy or minority rights. The early attempts to break up Nigeria derived from the above issues. Also speaking, the Afenifere leader, Pa Adebanjo, that President Muhammadu Buhari has all the wrong people in his cabinet. Adebanjo said that the thing that will save Nigeria is to change the 1999 constitution because it is fraud. Anything outside that, there is no future for Nigeria. He said corruption is worse in Nigeria now than it has ever been because of the people Buhari surrounds himself with. We need to ask ourselves why the North has more states and local governments than other parts of Nigeria. The military made it so to favor the North. The late sage chief Obafemi Awolowo wanted a constitution that would make every region in Nigeria grow at their own pace. And that is why Nigerians are clamoring for restructuring, because each region was dependent on clear autonomy. Nigerians want restructuring and dialogue to rebuild trust in Nigeria. We must beg President Muhammadu Buhari to agree to what the people actually want. And on the part of the Northern Elders Forum, which actually brought about all these things as well, he has said that the future of Nigeria does not need the All Progressive Congress and also the People's Democratic Party to change fortunes. He therefore charged Nigerians to vote for an individual who is interested in the development of the country. He said that the North has paid the biggest price for the failure of President Muhammadu Buhari. He therefore says that it is not needed and it is unusual or reasonable for anybody to attribute Buhari's failure to Northerners. He said the people in the North have the wrong person in office because they are the first victims of the misgovernance of President Muhammadu Buhari. Therefore, in his opening remarks, Executive Director of Ripple Center of Investigative Journalism, Mr. Sam Ibimiri, reiterated the importance of the gathering, saying that it was to redress the national issues due to the widening gulf among the populace. Thanks for listening to the news. Good evening.